Hey everybody, Tyler here at the Evinced Cafe. If you've seen part one of our series on AI, and even if you haven't, you probably know that it's tricky to use AI for digital accessibility. Stay tuned, and I'll show you what we figured out. The promise of AI for Evinced is that we can use it to suggest accessible code to a developer as they work. Not just that, but the code will be specific to what they're working on and ultimately their company and even personal style. But the key problem here is accuracy, and consistent accuracy at that. When Evinced recommends code, it needs to be both appropriate and accessible all the time. So our approach breaks down into three pieces. Expertise. First, we store up our expertise about the kinds of elements that developers are typically working on, and we make that expertise available on the fly. To do this requires the use of your first tech term of the day, vector embedding. Suffice to say, it's a way of representing non-numerical things as numbers, and it's a super efficient technique used by many leading companies. Intent. Second, we use AI to determine the developer's intent at the point of their cursor. What kind of component are they trying to code up? Is it a tab list or something else? That's critical because knowing what they're working on means we know not just how to code that element, but all of its states and attributes. That is, how it's supposed to work on the page, look, and respond to user input. Guardrails. Last, once we have a rough idea of the developer's intent, we can query the AI system in a clever way to make sure that it only returns code that passes our expertise check. We do this with some fairly elaborate prompt engineering, which is your second tech term of the day. Simply put, asking questions of AI systems like ChatGPT requires a lot of skill and experience. Here's a simple example. I'm going to ask this generative AI system to make me an image of a house in a field. You and I probably think that field means some sort of plants, but the system sure doesn't. Okay, time for some prompt engineering. I'll specify field of sunflowers. That's better. But now, I don't want a modern-style house. I saw a cute Bavarian house in Germany a few years ago, so I'll specify that. Ouch. Not sure what this Frankenflower thing is. So, more prompt engineering. Instead of using the word Bavarian, I'll use the word traditional. And boom. Aside from the sunflower on the roof. So, I think you get the picture, even if this AI system doesn't. Using AI to help write accessible code requires accessibility expertise, understanding developer intent in real time, and extensive prompt engineering. Next time you hear somebody say they're using AI to help on digital accessibility, make sure their approach involves all three. The last thing you want is a sunflower on your roof. That's all for today, folks. See you next time here at the Evinced Cafe.